Excuse me, but why do the three of us have to be here?
Why you want to just...
Because we're all going to ask your boyfriend his personal life story.
Is this starting?
It's already started.
Oh, it already started.
We're recording, my darling.
Oh, I'm sorry.
The notorious... Boy, the light is really... Right, I wonder what will happen if we do that.
Yeah, that's
a little
better.
Great.
All right.
The notorious S.T. Joshi, who has... Books up the wazoo. Now tell us about some of your books.
Well, there's just a lot of stuff coming out. Number of things devoted to Lovecraft, particularly. A collection of essays about the mythos. I don't think there has ever been a volume of this sort. Anyway, this is a bunch of essays called Dissecting Cthulhu by all the leading authorities. Robert Price, Will Murray, Stefan Szymanowicz, you name it. There are about 22 essays.
Are they all... old orders?
They're all reprinted, yes, I believe. A lot of them from Crypt of Cthulhu, a lot of them from Lovecraft Studies. And I put this together. It's called Dissecting Cthulhu and coming out from Miskatonic River Press in the fall, I think.
Hi, Tom!
Yeah, so Tom Lynch is doing a good job with this book. It'll have Robert Martin's great essay about Arkham Country and things like that. Marco Frenchkowski wrote a great little piece on Hali. I don't know if you remember that from Crypt of Cthulhu, but it has some really good stuff. Now for Larry Roberts's Arcane Wisdom imprint, I have done two volumes of the collected revisions and collaborations of Lovecraft with extensive annotations by me. This is the first time that these stories have been annotated. And I found a lot of interesting stuff about them, about the mound, for example, the southwestern background of the mound, stuff like that. So this is going to be two volumes. The first volume is pretty close to ready. It'll probably come out later this year. The second volume next year. In addition to that, Larry had me compile a two-volume set of Lovecraft's favorite horror stories. This is a project that I've been working on for a long, long time, and I'm glad to see this is finally coming out. It has a lot of the stories that Lovecraft not only liked, but that he was influenced by, things like The Sin Eater by Fiona MacLeod, or Ancient Sorceries by Algernon Blackwood, and a lot of pretty even obscure stories like Ooze by Anthony M. Rudd, which I think appeared in the very first issue of Weird Tales. Mm-hmm. Not the best story in the world, but Lovecraft got a lot of nuggets from that story for the Dunwich Horror. So I think it's an important source for him, and it's very hard to find that story. So I assume that that set of two volumes will come out probably sometime next year. So yeah, lots of stuff going on.
How's life as a novelist?
Well, yes. I have written a novel with Mr. H.P. Lovecraft as the lead character. I call him Howard throughout, and in fact sometimes I actually refer to him as Howard Lovecraft, so it's clearly him. It starts out as a pretty straight historical novel. It's set in mid-1914, June 1914 in fact, just, you know, a little couple months before the outbreak of World War I. He's, of course, living alone with his mother in Providence. And eventually he meets up with all sorts of strange characters, including... Well, he takes a trip to England in the company of a person whom he thinks is his father. His father did not die in this scenario in 1898. He's kept on living in the shadows and gets back in touch with Lovecraft in 1914 and says, "We have an important mission that requires us to go to England." And he meets in England Arthur Machen, Lord Dunsany, Algernon Blackwood, M.R. James, and William Hope Hodgson. And along the way, Lovecraft's father has dug up Ambrose Bierce, who also didn't die in early 1914, and he comes along for the trip also. Sure. So I hope it's an entertainment. I don't think it's a very good novel in the abstract sense of the term, but it'll be an entertainment. My agent hasn't gotten around to reading this thing yet, but so I don't know if it's going to appear from an actual commercial press or just from a small press. I have a feeling it'll end up in the small press, but I think kind of where it belongs.
And you started your own film festival?
Yes. The Seattle Art Museum has asked me to assemble a kind of film festival. We're calling it Lovecraft's Visions. This is set for October 7th, 8th, and 9th here in Seattle at the Art Museum. And we'll show as many as 12 films, you know, long and short. Beginning, of course, with The Haunted Palace and going all the way up to the recent Whisper in Darkness film that the H.P. Lovecraft Historical Society has put together. There will also be two panel discussions, one on Lovecraft's life and work and influence, the other one on Lovecraft's films. And we hope to have some good people on those panels, including Willem here himself. Marianne, I hope, will come, and you know, people like Mark Laidlaw wants to come. I hope Greg Bear will come. Other locals, because we frankly can't afford to pay people to get up here. But you know, Philip Haldeman out from Redmond will hopefully put in an appearance. And we'll have, you know, some of the you know, independent films. I think I've scheduled Brian Moore's Cool Air, which I really like. And of course, my favorite sort of pseudo Lovecraft film, which is Peter Weir's The Last Wave, which I think is really one of the most haunting and cosmic films ever made. And if somebody on that set hadn't read The Shadow of Time, I'd be dumbfounded. So yeah, that's set for October 7th, 8th, and 9th. So you know, you'll hear more about that in the course of time.
Why don't you all introduce yourself in the back there?
Yes.
Oh, well, I'm Marianne. And by the way, ST, have you said anything about your mysteries?
Well, that's sort of old news now, because I published two volumes of mysteries. One, a novel called The Removal Company. The second book is a pair of novellas published in the double format, you know, like the old days doubles.
Mm-hmm.
Both of these books coming out from Borgo Press. So the second one has two, you know, well, one a short novel, the other a novella, called Conspiracy of Silence and a Tragedy at Sarsfield Manor. Now, the only interesting things about that is that the Tragedy at Sarsfield Manor is actually a short novel that I wrote all the way back when I was 21 years old in 1979 and then totally reworked, although I ended up using quite a few passages from that original work of 1979 in the new version. I just cut out a lot of the stupid, boring stuff and, you know, shrunk it down to like a 25,000-word novella. But I think those are interesting. The first book, Removal Company, did get a nice review in Publishers Weekly. The guy didn't like the second one so much, but I actually think the Conspiracy of Silence is a superior work to the first one.
Now, some of your books have come out in the ebook format and are available from Amazon. I understand Dark Wings is available from Amazon in
Black
ebook
Wings.
Form?
Black Wings, yes. Black Wings is available in ebook format, a Kindle format, from PS Publishing. That's a UK firm, but I believe that you can get it through the US Amazon site. Also, and quite inexpensive, isn't it? It's only like $5 or $6.
Yeah, it's like $5.50. Though the hardback is certainly a very high quality hardback and worth the purchase. Mm. But
you
absolutely have to have your Lovecraftian horror edited by Joshi Fix, Amazon's the way to go.
On that score, yeah, the Black Wings should be coming out in a trade and possibly even a mass market paperback sometime next year from Titan Books, although we're still debating with them. They have actually not signed the contract, but I hope they will go ahead and sign it. In fact, they've contracted for Black Wings 1 and 2. Black Wings 2 will come out from PS Publishing in March of 2012. Pete Crowther of PS already wants me to do a Black Wings 3. He wants me to get that done by fall of 2012 so that it can come out for the World Fantasy Convention in Brighton, England, in fall of 2013. So that'll be three anthologies. I also have an anthology of largely reprint stories, basically my favorite Cthulhu Mythos stories. It's called Spawn of the Green Abyss. The title being, of course, the 1946 story by C. Hall Thompson, which I think is a really good story. I don't know who's going to publish that, but that's my agent is negotiating with that. I'm also doing a lot of books for Centipede Press, a number of titles. I can't mention some of them because they're still in the planning stages and we're not quite certain about them yet. But, for example, I did assemble a volume of Maurice Lavelle's Grand Guignol stories, tales of mystery and horror. Lovecraft liked Lavelle, although he's not a supernatural writer, but this volume is a big, big volume containing not only a lot of short stories, but two short novels. In fact, everything basically that Lavelle had translated into English. The novel The Grip of Fear and the novel Those Who Return. Lovecraft actually owned a copy of the latter novel. So that's coming out. I've put together a complete collection of the stories of John Metcalfe, the British writer. Those are pretty hard to find nowadays. Ashtree Press did a volume of Metcalfe stories, but they didn't include all the stories. They included only stories that they thought were weird or ghostly. I decided to include all his stories from his two major collections and whatever else, you know, uncollected stories there were. So that'll come out from Centipede Press also later this year. And we have a number of other things that are in the planning stages.
Okay, now...
So, Mary, you want to introduce yourself? This is my girl, Mary. So, guess he's shy and doesn't want to talk, but...
I've been having problems with YouTube, so we may have... I'm going to just try and record for the full 15 minutes. The last time I tried to do this today, we were cut off like at 8.5 minutes. So, if... I apologize to all of you and to all of you.
Yes.
If this is the case.
Well, we still have a couple more minutes.
We have a couple more minutes. I've tried to convince ST that we're going to do a group singing. Mm-hmm. I've had many requests for your melodious voice.
Well, I'll tell you. Remember, I only sing in a group. I sing in a choir, and I only usually sing classical. Not really up to singing anything popular or you know, things like that. Anyway, I'm not in good voice either particularly, but I'll tell you, my choir does record most of its concerts. The Northwest Chorale, if you want to look at their website, they will, I think you can buy some of their CDs, and I'm on there. You wouldn't be able to hear me probably. You wouldn't know which voice is mine, or you shouldn't be able to tell. Also, recently, just last May, the Northwest Chorale performed Haydn's Creation with the Northwest Symphony, and they recorded that concert, and I think that'll be available through the Northwest Symphony, so you might want to look for that also. In fact, I'd like to get a copy of that because I think that performance went reasonably well, at least for the choir. But not sure I want to sing right at this moment otherwise.
Any questions, Greggy? You have been so silent.
I'm just soaking it all in. Hello, hello, hello.
Oh, well, I want to point out that ST's Mystery Devil is also available as an ebook.
Oh, that's right.
I have it in my purse.
There you go. There you go. That's a painless way. And that's probably pretty inexpensive.
And what is the title of that? You haven't told the title, have you?
Yes, Conspiracy of Silence and the Tragedy at Sarsfield Manor.
Okay.
Is the first one available as an ebook?
No,
I don't think it is. Yeah, because Borgo Press only went to the ebook format fairly recently. Earlier books aren't there yet. I do have a couple other things to mention. I'll tell you what. Penguin is about to release my, not about to, but in the fall will release my edition of Arthur Machen. Finally got Machen into Penguin Classics. And this means, by the way, that I will have edited all the so-called of Lovecraft's modern masters in Penguin. That is to say, Arthur Machen, Lord Dunsany, Algernon Blackwood, and M.R. James, and then Lovecraft himself. Those, to me, are the five modern masters of weird fiction of that era. And the Machen book, I'll tell you, has a sensational preface by Guillermo del Toro. He is a fine writer in his own right, and he has a very sophisticated understanding of Arthur Machen. The book is worth getting just for his preface, I think. So pick that up. That should come out around September or October. Around the same time, I will have my Library of America edition of Ambrose Bierce. And that's an important book because that combines, it's a big omnibus which will contain Tales of Soldiers and Civilians, Can Such Things Be, The Devil's Dictionary, and a couple of other things like The Bits of Autobiography, which is a very poignant memories of the Civil War by Bierce. and some uncollected or you know lesser known stories, including one of my favorites, the Ashes of the Beacon, which is a futuristic story. So that's coming out in the fall.
Okay, we're out of time.
Okay.
I hope this works. Bye.